Brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, praise the Lord, hallelujah. Let us study another parable today. A sower sows seeds. The seed is the word which is of the kingdom of God. And we receive the seeds in the soil of our choice. All parables contain mysteries of the kingdom of God. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13, verse 9 says, Jesus says it, who has ear to hear, let him hear. That is, if you have spiritual desires for the kingdom of God, you will listen to this. Otherwise, you will not listen. Verses 10 and 11, he says, verse 10, and the disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou unto them in parables? And 11, he replies, Jesus says, he answered unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. Every parable has mysteries. It is revealed to the disciples of God, and it is hidden from others. Others study them as stories and interpretations, and they have a good time. Jesus says in verses 12 to 18 that ungodly religious hypocrites get worse and worse, and the godly people get blessed, see the kingdom of God in spirit, and will receive the kingdom of heaven as an inheritance. Let us see how Jesus teaches the parable to his disciples. He who receives the seed decides which soil to plant the seed, but the sower does not decide where to sow. It appears in the parable that the sower decides and throw the seeds around. Please notice how Jesus hides the mystery to the Pharisees in the parable. And Jesus says about the sower, the seed, and the soil, but not about the person who receives the seed to the people like Pharisees and scribes. It appears that the sower is out of his mind and throws seeds around like a maniac, throw all over, but not as a farmer. The farmer sow properly. And verse 3 says, and he speaks many things unto them in parables, saying, behold, a sower went forth to sow. A sower is the one he begins with. He went forth to sow. The sower sowed seeds, and it is the word of God about the kingdom of God. See, it is a figure of speech. He says seeds, but actually the word of God preaching. That's what he calls the sower sowing. And verse 4 says, some seed fell in the wayside. And verse 5 says, some fell upon the stony places. Verse 7 says, some fell among the thorns. Verse 8 says, others fell in the good ground. All the verses say the seed fell. See, it is a mystery there. We have to be careful in studying there, otherwise you will not catch it. He says a sower sowed. Now he said the seed fell. How did the seed fell in different kinds of places? Did they fly and land there wherever the seed wanted to land it? No. Even the sower did not intend to throw them there. It's not the sower's intention. Then Jesus explains it again to his disciples. In verse 20, he says, he received the seed into stony places. The guy who received it, he is the one who chose the stony places. Verse 22 say, he received the seed into among the thorns. And one is among the thorns, one is among the stony places. And verse 23 says, he received seed into good ground. He decided to put in the good ground, not the sower, the receiver. In every instant, the seed fell there because the owner or the person of the place who received the seed, and he put them there or he sowed them wherever he wanted. Let me explain in our way. Say, a paper boy delivers a soliciting paper to me, and I received it, and I throw it in the garbage. So I received in the garbage. A sale paper came to me. I kept it in the kitchen sink, the kitchen counter, for until the next shopping day, and then throw it away. An important freebie package came, and I put it in the kids' toy pile, and the dog and the kids tore them apart, and they played with it for a while. They had a good time, and they destroyed it. This is how I received the things which are not important to me. If it's not important, I put them in a place. I throw it away. I want them to be destroyed. And if the word of God, the kingdom of the kingdom of God is not important to us, if it's not important to us, this is the way we will treat the word of God and the messenger who brought the word of God. We throw them around, we insult them. So because we have no respect for the word of God, that's why we treat them that way. Then another example, the UPS man delivers a computer to me. And I told him to put it in my desk, and I opened it and set it up, initiated it, and went to work with it. And it became my computer. I spent a lot of time to do the work with my computer, and it became a part of my life. If the seed, the word of God's kingdom come to you, if it is important to you, you will plant them in an important place, then the place that you plant it, and you will decide your eternal destiny. If you put in a good place, you nourish them, all these kind of things, that will lead you to eternal destiny, eternal life. You will inherit the eternal kingdom. If you have that in mind, you will place the seed in a prominent, better, good land, good soil. So, is it you put it on the wayside or a stony place among the thorns or in good soil of your life? Where do you put it? You put it in a cheap place, and it will not grow and a little bit of soil. But the thing is, your eternal destiny depends on it. And if we see, like the preachers preach philosophies, theories, and to make the sower and the seed as the prime actors of this parable. It is we are the prime actors of the parable, because we are the one to decide where we're going to place the seed, how we're going to nourish the seed, so that we may get the benefit and we may receive the kingdom in heaven. It's not the sower. Many preachers teach many kinds of deviations from this parable. So they tell us to think about the sower, and they say the sower is Jesus Christ. He sows the seed in every nook and corner of every street and every church, beginning from the wayside, the stony place, and all the places, wherever. That means Jesus is so liberal and those kind of things. It is a very liberal concept, but it's not true. But Jesus says in this parable that all kinds of soils amounts to nothing, because they are all good for nothing. Only the good ground is the one give the fruits. And all grounds are not okay. Preachers say everything is okay, even if it's bad, evil, everything's okay. Jesus accepted. That's a kind of twist. It's not the truth. And then they say that we must bring, so they make us evangelists, the seed of evangelism, a sort of seed of salvation to everyone, even to people like the demons and even evil people. You got to go to them and you got to talk to them with love and those kind of things. And they will have a chance to go to heaven. So whatever, they wanted even the demons to take it to heaven. They say that Jesus wants us to scatter the seeds around with everywhere. And they have no clue about this parable. Jesus Christ teach one thing and they say something else. And they don't understand this. And Jesus made them blind, and they think that they see everything. And they don't even know what salvation is. How could they save the whole world? They have a very liberal mind to include even demons and angels put in the same basket, and they want to take them both to heaven. So that's the way they teach. It's a kind of exciting and a kind of a, everything is inclusive and Jesus won't reject anything and everything. See, that's kind of a lie of the Satan, but it is very, very prominent. But Jesus Christ says that that he will reveal his mystery only to his disciples, not to everybody. Why is not everybody? Because they don't have the heart to receive it. They have the worldly mind, they have a lustful mind, they're evil, they have no godly mind, they don't have the mind, so don't put the pork before the pigs. And God does not say, put it to everybody and choose. Just they reveal who are worthy to receive it and give it to them and reveal it to them so that they may nourish, they inherit the kingdom of heaven. But not to everybody. But, you know, preachers are very liberal-minded and they include everybody in there. So, all different kinds of soils are not okay. And God gives seeds to every good soil. And it is the only one that gives fruit. And all other soils failed and they were rejected and they are worthless. Why do you receive the seed and how do you use it for the kingdom? How do you use it? In verse 4 and 19, Jesus says that if we threw the seed of the kingdom of God in our wayside, that means if we talk about God's kingdom to the people who come to the doorsteps or by the way we walk by the I mean, it's not serious, just a kind of loose talk. We pick up a conversation with anybody without any seriousness. That is the way. If that is the way, that's a wayside talk. Then the devil will pick it up, it will amount to nothing. Even the preachers tell some of the truth to you, it will be taken away by the devil immediately and you will amount to, you will know nothing after that. Then Jesus tells in verses 5 and 6, the explanation in 20 and 21, that means 5 and 6 say the thing and 20 and 21 he gives the explanation. That if you are a religious person, pick up the kingdom message in your excitement and use it to put in the show, and if things do not work out the way you expected, if tribulation comes in because of your belief in God or belief in doctrine, and you will get disappointed, fail, and you will quit. He's talking about a little more serious people. If they get excited and they get involved, all these kind of things, but not in the excitement, but in the godliness, get in the life, then you will stay, otherwise you will fail. Then Jesus explained in verses 7 and 22 that our well-being and riches. Again, God blesses here. That's the way we take it. And in this world, it's actually is not the blessing of the towards the kingdom in heaven, because that those blessings will not take us to heaven. I mean, to inherit heaven. Put it that way. They are deceitful for spiritual purposes. When they increase, the deception will be to pay our attention to the riches, we're working for that and thinking that they are the blessings of God. The more we get it, the more we are blessed. Our riches will choke our spirit to death. Our godliness will become a religion, and we'll put up the religiosity or that thing, but the desire towards building up the empire in this world or get more blessings in this world will choke up the spirit to death, and our godliness will become become religion, the religiousness, and it will put an end to the purpose of the kingdom of God in heaven. It is deception. It's a blessing, of course, it's in the world, but if you hang on to that, and if you may forego the kingdom in heaven. So the important thing is the inheritance in the heavenly kingdom. Don't lose that. Good ground brings 30, 60, and 100-fold for the kingdom. And verse 8 and 23, verse 8 he says, but others fell in good ground and brought forth fruit, some a hundredfold, and some 60-fold, some 30-fold. And verse 23, he says, but he that received the seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it, and which also beareth fruit and bring forth some hundredfold, some 60-fold, and some 30. And Luke writes the same passage, and he adds one more phrase to that, and that's Luke chapter 8, verse 15. That those who have honest and good heart understand the word. So it is important to follow Jesus Christ with honest and good heart, but not with pride for a show. Mark chapter 2, chapter 4, verses 2 to 20, and Luke chapter 8, verses 4 to 18 also say the same parable in the same way. So godly people receive the word of God, and it is about the kingdom of God in heaven. They will yield fruit to God, see, and then God will give the inheritance. We give 30, and that much inheritance we receive. We yield 60, and then that much. So hundredfold, there will be New Jerusalem. So we give fruits to God in three different levels. That's what the scripture says. And so also we may get the inheritance accordingly. And that also we will get in three different levels of inheritance we'll have in heaven. And we'll, so the parable ends here. It's not give much explanation, but the 30 and 60 and 100 fold, I have explained I've given a link, two links in the transcript. So you may see that. If you're interested, you can study that. Thank you for listening. May God bless you and be with you. Amen.